Tonight we are talking Springbank, and well, a Springbank is a little bit of a love-hate relationship. I love to drink it, I hate to pay for it, and very difficult to find. And of course I'm talking about the 10-year-old Palo Cortado, and very difficult to find here in Belgium. I've been looking all over the place. You can get a 10-year-old 46% ABV, but when you look at the higher ABV whiskies like this one, 55% ABV, of course non-chill filtered, no color added, it's difficult to find. Now I was quite excited to see that the shop where I normally buy samples from have some available. The bottle was of course sold out, the full bottle, so we only have samples left. And yeah, I pushed the button, I have to try it. I may be late to the party on this one. It is a 2023 release. When I looked online in the UK, the distillery was selling it for £90. Then my shop online was selling it for €120. And when you look at Whisky Base now, you see the average price of this baby is going to cost you almost €500 for a bottle. Now for me that is absolutely ridiculous. It's crazy. I saw it for online for a sample €13.50. I think that is a reasonable price considering 500, and of course looking quite forward to giving this a nose and a taste. So 10 years old, it was matured for 6 years in ex-bourbon barrels, and then they moved it for 4 years in the Palo Cortado Sherry cask from Spain. And yeah, it's a sherry monster. Well, I hope it is a sherry monster. I do like a sweet whiskey. I do like a sweet whiskey with a hint of peat in it. So quite looking forward to finding something that's special. Well, maybe not always so special, because once you find something, you really like it and you realize a bottle is going to cost you so much, then it was not really worth it in my opinion. I'm looking for things that I cannot afford. So on this one, there was 10,200 bottles. It's still available if you are willing to go deep into the pockets and buy something. It is there, you just need to do a little bit of digging. And before we get into the whiskey, just a quick reminder, I do have a Patreon account. Thank you for my Patreons. That money that are donated every month goes to children in South Africa. I don't use it to buy whiskey, I buy my own. I also have a membership that you can join for a small fee every month. That money also goes to children in South Africa, as well as all the ad revenue. Not much, you'll be surprised if you get 25 to 30 euros a month on ad revenue. So definitely not Mr. Beast making millions, but of course that money goes to children. So back to the whiskey. It's all about the whiskey. And of course, if we can buy some food for children in South Africa, all the better. So the whiskey itself, natural color, non-chill filtered, bloody expensive one. The color, nice golden copper color coming out. Leg-wise, it's not really a viscous one. There's some legs, fast legs, thin legs forming, quickly running down the glass. But the aromas that come off when you pour it, immediately you are hit with this lovely sweetness that comes out. And that is what I like about this one. It is sweet, but not Pedro Ximénez sweetness. It's a different type of sweetness. There's a lot of fruity components, that dark fruit components that comes out, that dried fruit components that comes out. There's a little bit of a vanilla. And I also get some nice, juicy, fat red apples. I get that raisin notes, definitely. And then I If you think about the alcohol, 55% ABV, so it's definitely a strong boy. But even with a little bit of an agitation, you don't get that. If I would have done this blind, I would have guessed maybe 43%, maybe 45 or 6% if I really push it and I do wake it up quite a lot. And I stick the nose in, there's just that quick hit of that alcohol, and immediately it disappears into something that's nice, light, sweet, friendly, fruity, dried fruit component. It is stunning for me on the nose. Now, there is a little bit of peat in it. I really struggling to find it on the nose. It's just not there. It reminds me like one of like Johnny Walker, one of those that suggest that there might be a peat note in it, something similar to this, but on a completely different level for me. It is lovely. There's a little bit of a leather note comes in. I get a little bit of a dusty oak dust note. And every time that I go back, it feels like it becomes friendlier. That little alcohol is disappearing, and it just leaves you with that well-balanced, sweetish notes on the nose with all the fruity components. Absolutely a stunner for me on the nose. And I would even go so far as suggesting, of all the Springbanks that I've tried, for me, this is the most interesting one. But we, of course, we have to drink it as well. Cheers. And that taste, that 55% alcohol is definitely there. It's a little bit of an alcohol spicy note. But the surprising thing is the sweetness of it. And it's so much sweeter on the taste than on the nose. And it is absolutely fantastic. But take it a small sip. Go start small, move your way up to a little bit of a bigger sip. It is, the sweetness are inviting. It is, for me, one of those whiskies that I will probably never add water to it because the level for me is just perfect. Now, I'm in Belgium, Brussels, 28 degrees today. It is now almost 10 o'clock at night. It is still unbearably hot. It is a weather that you suffer without air conditioner. But, of course, back to the whiskey. Now, I do get a little bit of a toffee note. I get a little bit of a jam, almost like strawberry jam, sweet strawberry jam. Let me just try again. So, sherry, a little spicy note. I get a hint of a bitter note. Now, you expect it. It's Spanish oak. You expect a little bit more tannins to come out of that. And it's definitely there. And I think every time that you go back, if especially in a short period of time, there's going to be a little bit of a bitter build up. But it is so sweet, you need that little bitter note just to balance it off. Try again. From the nose to the taste, it's friendly. That the raisins come out. There's a little bit of a toffee note that comes out, a little caramelly note. That dried fruit components are there. It's a little bit of a peachy note. And I've also realized yesterday when I started doing my notes and tasting them, I left a glass for about 4 hours, 3 hours, and I took the empty glass and I nosed it, and it was just incredible. That empty glass brought out so much flavors and aromas coming up. So from nose to taste to empty glass, it is really fantastic whiskey. Now that smoke, again, not on the nose, but on the taste, I do get a little bit a hint, just a little bit of a background that suggests, and I think a lot of people, when you tell them there's smoke in it, they will tell you they don't get it. I struggle to find the smoke, but it is there, especially that little aftertaste leaves a little bit of a distant smoke or old fire note that leaves it in the mouth. And it is well balanced, sweet, lovely, ticking all the boxes, high ABV. Now, the only thing that is left, am I willing to pay $400, $500 for a bottle which initially cost $90? Definitely not. If I can get a bottle for $90, I will buy two of them. If I can get it for $100, $110, I will buy two of them. If they offer me it for $500 or $400 or $300, no way in hell I'm going to pay that. But it is a lovely whiskey. And of course, if you cannot buy a full bottle, find that pub that do have something like this. Give it a try, you definitely will not be disappointed. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like, share and subscribe. And I see you next time. Cheers.